Welcome back to Pain-Free Living. Again, my name is Dr. Andrew Grecki, physical therapist, owner of Superior Physical Therapy, and today we're talking about how to find a natural solution to knee pain. You just learned about the two most common types, which are osteoarthritis and meniscus tears, and now I want to kind of talk to you about how those are probably not the cause of your pain. And so let's start out with the studies that I have. I have two studies that look at both of those conditions. So osteoarthritis, first of all, we have a study that was called an asymptomatic imaging study, which means that they looked at thousands of people that are having no knee pain, and they gave them an MRI for their knee, and what they found was pretty fascinating. 76% of people over the age of 63 have evidence of osteoarthritis in their knees in the study, but only 13% of those people reported having pain. So what does that mean? Well, that you have to come to the conclusion then that osteoarthritis is not a direct correlation or causation or cause of pain. And so we're going to get to what the causes are in a second. Now, a second study looking at meniscus tears was a systematic review and published by the British Medical Journal. And what they came to the conclusion is that they looked at people that had surgery for their meniscus, an arthroscopic surgery for the meniscus, and then people that went through physical therapy. And what they found was that there was no difference between the two groups. So the recommendation after reading that study from the BMJ, or the British Medical Journal, in 2017 is that people should not have surgery for a meniscus tear. They should go to physical therapy. You can find all these studies published on our website. And so if you want to go check that out at thesuperiortherapy.com, you're more than welcome to read all you want. I love reading studies because they help us understand better what's changing in the world of medicine, particularly in this case. So really that leads us to the next question of, okay, if I have arthritis or if I have a meniscus tear, which basically gives us 90% of the people out there dealing with knee pain, what's the real cause of my pain? If these studies indicate that it's not those two things. So let's dive deep into what causes knee pain. Remember earlier I talked about how the knee is stuck in the middle with nowhere to go. It's stuck in the middle of the foot and the hip, okay? So the motion that the foot and ankle does affects the knee, and the motion that the hip does affects the knee. And essentially the knee is stuck between the two. And so what happens? Well, let's use that rotation, that turning in and out. Remember, the knee only does 5 degrees of that. It hates to do it. Well, the problem with that is, let's just go and use that example for a second. When we know that when we're walking and our foot hits the ground, that the foot flattens out like a pancake. Most of you would recognize, yeah, my foot flattens out when I move. Especially when you do things like bending and squatting, the foot flattens out like a pancake. That's normal, by the way. When that happens, however, when the foot flattens out, it grabs onto the lower leg bone and it turns the lower leg bone in 30 degrees. You can see that in this image. The foot flattens out, grabs the lower leg bone, and it turns it inward 30 degrees. Now, that lower leg bone goes up to the knee and says to the knee, hey knee, you gotta turn in 30 degrees. And the knee says, wait a minute, I can only do 5 degrees. But good thing I've got the hip upstairs and I can grab onto the femur and tell the femur to turn in. The hip is designed to move in 60 degrees. So now that's a good thing for the knee. And now that's a scenario where everybody's doing what they're supposed to do. Now, it's really common for us in the sitting culture that we're in, sitting for 10 hours a day on average, that the hips start to get a little stiff. Now, imagine if the hip doesn't turn in and the foot hits the ground, flattens out like a pancake, grabs onto the lower leg bone, turns the lower leg bone in, and the knee says, well, I can only do 5 degrees of that, 30 degrees. Hip, can you turn in? And the hip says no. Now you've got a knee that's forced to rotate more than it's designed to rotate. And that is a classic example of how the knee can be painful, right? The knee can be painful, but the real cause is actually because the hip is not moving properly. So that is a classic example. Now, what I tell people that are dealing with knee pain, well, and let's back up for a second. If you're in that scenario and your knee's hurting you, the first thing you're gonna do is go to the doctor and ask to get help, right? And what commonly happens is we get an image, an x-ray or an MRI that then tells us we have arthritis. And that can be very misleading because we first need to look at the foot and ankle and the hip to see if they're helping out the knee. And that is the recommendation that I have for you. Get your foot and your hip looked at first before you go down the path of picking on the knee. It's usually not the knee's fault.